Hello, in this video we will continue with the hash map. So in the last video we displayed several methods like contains, key, remove and so on. So let me just delete this. Okay, delete this part. And let me delete this also. Okay, so here, just to save some space. Right, so let me just run this. Okay, this is what we have. So, and also let me get rid of from this one. Says delete me. Okay. Okay, we don't need that anymore. Okay, so we have 3, 5, 61, 62. Okay. So now let's do this. So I want to get the set of these, okay? So set of these ones, and then let's display that. So here we have, I say set, okay? And in here the keys are the numbers, okay, integers. So here I say integer, and let me name this S1, okay? And here I populate this set from the key set, okay? So I say M1 dot key set, okay? So actually let me show this. Okay, key set, and as you see it returns the set of integers. Okay, and after that let me display this S1. Okay, so system out print line and S1. Okay, let me run this. Okay, we got the 3, 5, 61, 62. Okay, and also let me get the values. Okay, so there is a method. So let me show this. M1 dot okay, values. And what does it return? Collection. Okay, so collection is an interface. So let me choose this one, values, and on the left side we should have a collection. Okay, collection, but collection of what? String, right? So our values are string, and let me name this collection one. Okay, collection one, and then let's display that. So here system out print line, and let me say collection so that we know the distinction, the difference between them. So here I say col one. Okay, so now let's see how this works. Okay, so here it displays this, okay, on the screen. And then, as you see, we have some duplicates, okay? So now let's get rid of this. So how do I take from collection to set, okay? So in the collection, duplicates are allowed, but we know that in the set, the duplicates are not allowed. So here you cannot just convert from it because the number of items are different. So here we should create another set. Okay, so I say set, and so the values are string. Okay, and let me say S2. Okay, S2. And then, so here, We can have either a tree set or hash set. So let me just use hash set. Okay. So new hash set. Okay. And let's look at the constructor. This one creates a empty hash set, and this one it takes collection and creates, so populates from the collection to hash set. And when there are some duplicates, duplicates are removed, so they're skipped basically. So let me choose this one. And okay, so what do we have here? Collection is col 1. Okay, semicolon. Okay, and then let me display the this one as 2. System out print line, and then S2. Okay, and then S2. So let me run this. Okay, as you see, we have only 160, so the duplicates are eliminated. Okay, so now let's continue. And also consider that alright, so when I display this this map, okay, so as you see here, when I display in here, it display that in this format. So curly braces and then 3 equals whatever, and this equals, and then some column in between. And consider that I don't want to display them in this way. I want to display them however I want. Okay, so here, for example, I could say key is this, and then value is this one. Okay, so in that case, I want a way to process each pair. Okay, so in here we have we use a loop, for loop. Okay. Okay. So here I say, by the way, before this, let me also explain what entry set means. Okay. So entry set returns the pairs as a set. Okay. So you can put that in a set. So, for example, here M1 dot entry set. Okay, so what does it return? Set. So this is a set, okay, and then each element is an entry. Okay, so entry of the map. So this is an inner class, so entry, integer and string. So let me choose this one. Okay, so on the left we should have that. Okay, so we should have so set. Okay, set, and then each element is an entry of, okay, integer and string. String, and in here let me name this S3. Okay, S3. And then let me display S3 system out print line S3, and also let me do this S3. Okay, so let me run it. Okay, so S3 is okay. So we displayed it as a set, okay. Okay. Also, let me go over each entry one by one, and then we display however we want to display key, and then we display the value. Okay. So in here we have a for loop. Let me just do this. Okay, so that we can see. More. Okay, so we have a enhanced for loop. Okay, and in the enhanced for loop, we have this entry. Okay, this. So, all right, and then so this each element is an entry with the integer and string. Okay, and let me name this, for example, n, meaning entry. Okay, and then how do I get this? So what is each entry? So that is the entry set. Okay, so m1 dot entry set. Okay, so consider that this as a set of entries, and then so each element is an entry. Okay, and this is a set. Okay, all right, so in here let me say system out, and let me display each element at different lines. So I will say print line. Okay, so here I want to say, for example, k, okay, meaning key. And then, so how do I get the key? So from here, entry dot, okay, get key. And as you see, there is also get value. So get key, and then what do we want in the, so let me put a top character, and then value. Okay, value, and then n dot get value. Okay, and then it goes to the next line. Okay, so now let's see how this works. Okay, so it worked as we wanted. So it displays k and then 3 and value. So key and value. Okay, I hope this is clear to everybody. Have a nice day.